Hello everyone, this is Brian from My OC Bookkeeper. Today we're going to be going through how to set up a basic ledger for your business in Excel. If you already have advanced Excel skills, your best bet is probably to skip this video and go back and check out our channel where we'll also be putting some more advanced Excel videos, as well as some QuickBooks videos and some accounting and bookkeeping videos. So please check us out. If you aren't familiar with MyOC Bookkeeper, we are a bookkeeping, tax, and business consulting firm in Orange County, California, but we work with companies all over the country. So please feel free to check us out. Our website is www.myocbookkeeper.com. Great, so let's get going. So here you can see we have some columns. Now the columns you choose to use sort of depends on the kind of information that's important to you and the details of your business. But these are some examples of the basic kinds of columns you're likely to want. Here we have the date. Here you have the transaction, or basically some notes on the transaction. So for example, in this row, we have your June rent. Here we have a SAT textbook. Here we have Tanisha Hill's math and reading tutoring in June. You'll notice that the sort of theme here is tutoring. So we're just pretending we're doing a couple weeks worth, or about a week's worth of expenses and income for a small tutoring company. All right, so let's go through the rest of these columns here. So then here we have receipt or invoice. That's just a way that some people like to record whether or not they have filed away their receipt or their invoice appropriately. Again, that's optional. You see here, we put no for the calculators. So if you're just going through this, that could be a reminder that you want to go back and make sure you have filed away that receipt or relevant invoice as needed. Then we have a category here. This is the way you organize your income and expenses. So for the expenses, there's going to be different kinds of expenses, right? We have several kinds of expenses, which are supplies. So here you'll see a calculus textbook. We count as a supply. Then we have calculators. Count that as a supply. And an SAT textbook we count as a supply. We also have rent, right? So here the rent, that's an expense that we call rent. And we have our electric bill, we call that utilities. So the categories are just a way of organizing the information so that you can group it together and learn things about your firm. For example, what kinds of expenses are you having? What are your biggest expenses? You know, what was your total rent expense for the year, or your total utility bill for the year? How much money did you spend on calculators over the past 6 months, et cetera? Next, we have type. Type is a bit more generic. That's just gonna be whether something is an expense or income. In the case of income, we don't really have categories in this case because it's a fairly simple business. In some businesses, you might have different kinds of income, in which case you could put the category of income here. But in this case, it's all pretty generic, so we just call income the category and income also the type. So that is this column here. Then you have your debits and your credits. So when you have an expense, like for example our June rent here, that goes in the credit. And when you have income coming in, for example John Stevens June SAT tutoring, that's a debit. Now one little thing you can see here is you see these dollar signs. The way we got those there is we came up here and we clicked on this little dollar sign. Now, I already did that a moment ago, but we can go back here. Let's click this. So when you first open up or start working on the file, your numbers likely look like this. So if you want to convert them to dollars, you click on this dollar sign right here, and there you have the dollars. Okay. Now, let's keep going. Now we get to our balance. So for the balance, we want to combine. This is going to be a running balance, right? So let's see how we do this. First, you hit equals, right? Then your debits minus your credits, right? Because again, the debits are positive and the credits are negative. So there you have your balance. Now, if you're not familiar with the parentheses, that's just an accounting way of describing negatives. Now here again, we're going to do something a little bit different because this is going to be a running balance. So you hit equals. That's the first thing you hit in order to code a cell. So we're going to say equals the previous balance, which is I2, right? Then we're going to add any debits for this particular row, and subtract any credits for this particular row, and hit enter. And there we have the running balance. So as you can see here, we had $1,400 credit on the first, and then another $54 credit. So our running balance is negative $1,454. Now this is kind of interesting. What we can do here is drag this like so, and the formula we coded into this cell will be replicated in the cell below it. However, it will operate on that the given row which it's in. So for example, here you see our formula was I2 plus G3 minus H3. And by the way, you can hit F2 and it will light up these cells which are relevant to a given code. So this row, it's I2, here's I2 plus G3, here's G3 minus H3. And then when we pull this down here, it becomes I3 plus G4 minus H4. Go here, F2, it's going to be I4 plus G5 minus H5. So, and if you keep going down, it's going to be the same formula, just pulled down one row each time. So as you can see here by the end, we have running balance of $801. Okay, now, let's see here. Okay, so now something else we can do is sum these rows vertically. So say you want to know, we know our running balance. We know as of the 8th, where we've earned a net of $801 for the month. But what if we just want to know, what are our total number of debits? So let's go to this cell right here, equals, which means we're going to code it. And we're going to type in sum. Come here, click on sum. And that's a formula that Excel knows. And then you click here, the top row, or the top row, yeah. And then drag this down to the bottom row, hit enter, and then Excel will automatically sum this entire column. Now, if you hit F2 again, you'll see that it's summing this whole area here. Now, what we can do is we can drag this column to the right, and it will reproduce that formula, but move it over one column. So, if you see here, it's a sum of all of the credits. So, if you want to do a little check here, we can equals, that's going to enable us to code. And let's take this total and subtract our credits, and we get $801. So that's sort of a little check that shows us that we coded everything correctly, because our running balance of $801 matches the balance we create by independently adding the debits and credits. Okay, so that's the most basic stuff you need to know, sort of track your income and expenses. Some other little things that you can do, say you want to make this a little more visually appealing, we can come up here, see this little paint bucket, that's colors, so we can throw in some dark blue here, and then we can come down here, maybe a nice little light blue, there you go, and if you want, click this, is how you enable sort of cross-hatching and borders in your cells, so let's throw in some borders. And there you have a nice looking little ledger. Some other little things to know. Down here in this corner, this is the zoom function, so you can zoom in and out. Also, if you want, we can go back here. Say you want to add a row. So we come, let's see, come to row 3 here. We're going to click on that row, right click, and scroll down here and click insert. Now we have a new row here. We can add something. Say we forgot on the first. What happened? We got Michael Jones homework help. All right, so Michael Jones family played for some homework help. We got our receipt, or our invoice, excuse me. This is going to be income. Let's say income again. Because it's income, it's going to be a credit. So let's say the Jones family spent $100 on homework help. Now you'll see this column, or this result here, automatically updated, because when you added that row, it automatically was included in this calculation. But here, we're going to have to modify our calculation. So what are we going to do? Now remember, this top row is a little different than the others. It's just the debit minus the credit. But starting here, we're going to hit equals. We're going to hit this cell here, the balance. We're going to add our debit, our new debit, subtract our new credit. Oh, but it looks like we made a mistake here, my friends. Let's get that out of there. The income is going to be a debit. So we're going to come back here, go to the balance. We're going to add our debit, subtract and credit. And there we have it. And as you can see, this formula is the same formula we had here and running down there. It's this cell plus this cell minus this cell. And here we have same idea. But here we have to tweak this now because we added that row. So this is starting with the wrong balance. Because remember, when we made this formula, we initially input this as the first input. So we're going to have to fix this row. Go here. We could do two things. One, we could change this like so, right? Hit enter. That's one thing we could do. Or we could have just come here because this is the formula we're going to want to work going down through every row, and we can just drag that down. Either way, it'd have the same effect. But that's indicative of the fact you want to be careful when you go in and make changes that you don't have slight coding errors which can occur. And that is really a perfect example of something that could occur, which would put your numbers off if you're not careful. So it's always a good idea to run through and just sort of check your coding and make sure everything makes sense. And also, again, we have this check here, which can alert you to any problems. All right, and just as a general rule, another good thing to do is just when you're starting out with Excel, is just start playing around, you know? See what merge and center does. See, that kind of affects the visual aspect of a given cell. Play with the colors, play with borders. You can play around here with, this is, again, this converts a cell to a money format versus percentages, all kinds of things. You know, one of the best ways to learn is just to play around. So anyway, thank you for watching our video. Be sure to check back with my OC Bookkeepers channel. We're going to be putting a lot of great videos. Again, some introductory Excel accounting videos, some introductory QuickBook videos, and then as well some advanced videos on Excel, on QuickBooks, and some videos on bookkeeping and accounting outside of those particular applications. And also check out our website, www.myocbookkeeper.com. And feel free to reach out to us for all your bookkeeping, accounting, tax, and strategic consulting needs. All right. Thank you.